If we're trying to look up fill and return the rate, well, if we use VLOOKUP or XLOOKUP, because there's 1, 2, 3 duplicates, lookup functions can only get the first one. But what we want is we want to specify which one. We want a formula that'll look up fill but get the second one. And when I change this to 3, it'll get the third one. Now, I'm going to show you both methods, but as always, Microsoft 365 is so much easier than any version in history. And here's how it goes. We're going to use the filter function, and we want to filter the rate column. That's array, comma, include. Well, I'm going to say, hey, look through that column, and only pick when you're equal to whatever the name is. Close parentheses. Now, when I hit Enter, I get all three values. But now we have a lookup range, F2, that we can use in index. Now, index is a lookup function that needs a relative position. So when I type comma, row number or relative position, it's whatever we pick here. Close parentheses. And that's our formula. So easy in Microsoft 365. Now when I select 2, I get Phil's second value. And Joe, that's Joe's second rate. Now, the beauty of this is right there, F9, we only have 3 values, so we can actually use this. In earlier versions, we had to create a pattern of trues and falses for every row and then pick out the relative position. So whereas with filter, Joe is in the second position, when we use the methods in earlier versions, we have to get a 4 to pick it from the full data set. Now, we start with row. And row will give us 2 to 13. That's not quite what I want. So I subtract from it row of the first one. Now it'll get 2 minus 2 is 0. Close parentheses. So we subtract 1. If I hit the F9 key to evaluate, oh, it's Control Z plus 1. Luckily, I did F9 to see the mistake before we entered the formula, F9. And there's our 1 to 12. Now we need to filter these, because for Joe, we want 1, 4, and 10. Control Z. So we'll put parentheses around this, and we'll see the Excel 2010 or later version. We put that in parentheses and divide by, in parentheses, the logical test we used over in filter. And now when I hit the F9 key, divide by 0 error is the filter. But there it is, 1, 4, and 10. Control Z, and we want the second smallest. So we'll use aggregate. Now notice when I hit tab, it stole that parentheses. So I'm going to have to remember to put parentheses. The function I want is small, so that's 15, comma. The options argument gives us this 6, which allows us to avoid errors, which means the divide by 0 errors can be used as a filter, comma. There's the array. We come to the end, comma. And K, we use our 2, close parentheses. And when we enter this, this will give us the fourth position. Then we put it inside of index. There's our lookup values, comma. And that whole thing is row number. Close parentheses and Enter. Now let's learn a cool trick. I'm going to copy this, and I'm going to use Control CC. That copies it and then opens up the clipboard. If CC doesn't work, you have to come down to Options and allow CC to copy and open it the first time you copy. And I'm going to copy that part. And I'm also going to copy that part right there, Control C. So I have 3 formula elements. Now I hit Enter. In Edit mode, F2, I'll click the first part. And we'll use Small. Then inside array, we say if, and there's our logical test, comma, value of true, is that whole thing there. And we'll close parentheses and not use value if false, because inside the if, when we leave false out and hit F9, false is now the filter. But we get 1, 4, and 10. Control Z, come to the end, comma, and K is whatever is there. Close parentheses on small. All of that is like aggregate in row number. But when I close parentheses, I have to use the keyboard Control Shift Enter to get it to work. And you have to verify that the curly brackets are automatically put in by Excel. And there's our three methods. I look up Joe's first. There it is. All right, if you like that video, click that thumbs up, leave a comment, and subscribe, because there's always lots more videos that come from Excel is Fun. And if you want to watch more videos, check these out.